one of the co-founder of a company called Pointin. In Pointin, we are basically working on three areas: education reforms, rural empowerment, and promoting entrepreneurial culture amongst youth. In education reforms, we are building certain technology projects like Pointin Books, Pointin Jobs, and Pointin Projects. Our aim is to involve students in much closer to the industry, where students get a chance to work with the small industries, not necessarily big industries. So I'll give you an example. There are a lot of companies in auto or like in Vadwa who are struggling to find the right candidate because they are not able to pay those 20,000 salary with an engineer. Here we have a lot of students in engineering college or maybe in BCom or BSc, where they are not able to get the right experience. Only 10% of the students are getting the right experience. So it would be an ideal for a student to get that project from the industry where both the people getting benefit. For an industry, they are getting the high quality resource for at a cheaper rate. That's the benefit they are getting. For a student, they are getting the real world experience without spending any money. So this is the kind of model we are trying to build on. So we are using our technological expertise for that. Plus, we are doing a lot of events, a lot of awareness games across various colleges in Gujarat. So that forms a part of education reforms. In rural empowerment, we are building two small enterprises. One is Switley Designs and one is Pointin Outsourcing. In Switley Designs, we are creating a rural global marketplace for rural artisans. So you know, the most amazing part, a couple of days back, I met a designer, she was telling me proudly that our products are being made by NIT people. And I told her that our products are made by rural artisans. But the best part is our products are sold by students of Harvard and Stanford. So we have a lot of students over there who were interested in selling our products over there. So that's how the model has been created. Second thing, we pointed outsourcing, we have started two digital training centers, one near in Gandhinagar, one near Surat. So our aim is to involve students in, involve the rural people who are not into agriculture. Today only 10-20% people are into agriculture. Companies have started entering in the villages to take care of agriculture things. So there are a lot of people who need quality employment in their villages only. So our aim is to give them the training. So we have hired the computer trainers. Most of these trainers are teachers in the rural school. So we need not relocate anybody over there. We already have a guy who is already teaching to the rural people. In fact, we are paying that guy, in 2 hours he is getting the same pay what he is getting for the 8 hours of work in the school. So that's how we are creating an admired organization. So that will help us to create a certain organization in future. So that thing we are doing. Third thing is promoting entrepreneurial culture among students. In that, we have two things. One is we host this entrepreneurs forum in a similar way each month. So we have a lot of people, a lot of interesting people who came and present themselves. And then we create a certain action points with them that in future somebody wants to do some kind of business in their expert area, so they are more than willing to help those people. Second thing we have is Pointin TV, which works as a web television featuring inspiring entrepreneurs. So as of now, we've been recording all our Pointin talks in all these programs. But we've been meeting a lot of people. So a couple of days back, I met a guy. He stays in Maninagar. His name is Mr. Arvind Patel. He is known for his innovation. But the most amazing part is his story. In 1999, when we had a Prime Minister, Mr. Vajpayee, he talked about the Jai Jivan, Jai Kishan and Jai Vigyan. So he was building certain innovation, but nobody was recognizing him. So he went to Delhi. He went to Prime Minister's office. He convinced that his peon and all that. Somehow he got to this Prime Minister's office to the secretary guy. He spoke with that guy and next day there was a letter from PMO to the state government and all these agencies were working on the innovation. Then we had this news in 2001 or 2 that government of Gujarat bought 35,000 of these products. So the most amazing part, that guy is not able to speak English. When I met him, he was planning to write a letter to Prime Minister Manmohan Singh in English. So he asked us if you can help him that. So the most part is the kind of way he has. He says that I need not need anybody's help, I can do it on my own. So these are the people who will be featuring on Pointin TV. So that's about Pointin. Now I'll invite